StraightAllDay.com.
Now tuned in to the show where you learn the discipline to show up day after day to do the work, the confidence to put yourself out there boldly and authentically, and the mental toughness to continue showing up, doing the work, putting yourself out there even when the success you've expected to achieve has yet to be achieved. And on top of all this, you get a huge dose of personal initiative. That is the go-getter energy that moves you to go and make things happen instead of wait for things to happen. And then we put all this together into one framework, one mentality, one approach, one mindset, one lifestyle, one way of doing your thing. We wrote a book on the subject and we got this daily masterclass that is called Work on Your Game. My name is Dre Baldwin, also known as Dre All Day, and welcome to the show. And today's topic is how you can get yourself randomly, quote unquote, we use air quotes when we're saying that. How can you get yourself randomly found? How can you get discovered? How can you get people to know about you and know you maybe stumble into some success? How can you get a little bit lucky when it comes to discovery and attention, the way that maybe you have noticed some other people getting lucky when it comes to discovery and attention? I've had some people ask me questions about this or questions around this. Many times people are asking questions about how can I just get seen? How can I get some more exposure? Whether that's an athlete trying to get seen, whether it's an online marketer trying to get more, you know, eyeballs to their sales page or their funnels so they can sell their products. People just trying to acquire more clients. There are people all the time wondering how or asking about how can I get myself seen? Getting seen, heard, and known is, understand, first of all, it is not a lottery. Okay, getting yourself seen, heard, and known is not you just hoping that randomly one person comes across and finds you. Even though today's episode is about getting randomly found, it's not about this being your only strategy. You understand what I'm saying? Now, before I go further into the introduction, let me remind you, I have a text line where I want you to text me and tell me what from today's episode is going to most impact your actions moving forward. What are you going to do differently? Most importantly, differently, based on what you heard today. My number is 305-384-6894. Again, 305-384-6894. The number is down below also in the show notes in case you forget it. But what I'm going to share here today is how you will position yourself to get found by someone who may not necessarily even be looking for you. Someone who just randomly stumbles across you. I tell you, it's a great feeling when you're a person who's out there in your field, whatever that field happens to be. This could be online or offline. And you get a person who reaches out to you with an opportunity. And that opportunity could be them buying something from you. It could be them wanting to hire you or book you for something. It could be them just wanting to work with you. And you recognize it as, you know what, this is actually a good opportunity. And you find out from that person that they found you when they weren't even looking for you. They weren't even looking for exactly what you were doing, but they came across you and say, you know what, I was looking at this or looking at that, or I was talking to somebody and they just happened to mention you, and that's how I came across you, and now here I am offering you something, or I want to buy something from you, or I want to hire you for something. That's a great feeling, because then you can say to yourself, it's kind of like the validation of whatever you did up to the point that you got found, and a person who found you wasn't even trying to find you in the first place. So how can you set yourself up for this? That's what I'm going to tell you here today. Point number one, the topic once again, is how to get randomly found. First thing, share a consistent message and be active with that message. This is a pretty simple concept, right? Yet, many people do not follow it. First of all, in order for you to share a consistent message, you must have a consistent message. I think you all know what my consistent message is. I mean, it's the name of the show. What is your consistent message? Now, this consistent message you may not have the very first day that you begin. You may not have the 100th day that you've been in it or the 500th day that you've been in it, but despite that, this should be continually on your mind. If not consciously, then subconsciously, what is going to be my consistent message? What's the one message or idea that I want people to connect to my name so that when my name comes up, the first thing they think of is that thing? Or if someone happens to mention that thing, somebody's going to say, oh, you know about person ABC because you're the person who, you know, quote unquote, owns that message. You don't even have to own it on paper. When you own it in people's minds, you might as well own it on paper. Share a consistent message and be active. What is it going to be? The more often you share that consistent message, whatever it ends up becoming, the more seeds you are planting, and each one of those seeds is kind of like a possibility. It's like planting seeds for a tree or planting seeds for flowers. Every time you plant another seed, you are creating another possibility of getting yourself found. It's like if someone puts out a, you put a video on YouTube, or you put a bunch of videos on YouTube. Let's say you put 10 of them out there, gave yourself 10 opportunities to get found. You put 1,000 out there, now you've given yourself 100 times more opportunities to get found. You put 1,000,000 videos up there. I don't know if anybody has 1,000,000, but if you put 1,000,000 up there, you're giving yourself even more opportunities to get found. Why? Because you're continually putting yourself out there. You're planting seeds. If you put out 10 videos, maybe one of those 10 goes viral and that one produces all the opportunity that you need. Or you put out 100, maybe 10 of those 100 go viral. Now is even more opportunity that you get. But you got to be consistent in your message and just active in putting yourself out there, whatever it is. And at the same time, let me also offer this disclaimer with that consistent message. While you're figuring out your message, don't just sit on your couch and do nothing. Continue to put your stuff out there and sharing whatever it is that you're sharing, because as you're doing it in the process, you're going to come across what that consistent message is. I'll tell you this story of how it happened with myself. This whole work on your game thing, I was putting content out online before I started using work on your game. I started using work on your game intentionally and consistently probably about 10 years ago, but I was publishing content for 6 years before I got to that point. So I was putting out basketball videos and, you know, just working out and doing the workouts and the drills and stuff like that. Even started talking about the mental game stuff around 2000. And I started putting the videos out 2005. Started talking about the mental game probably around 2009. Started writing books in 2010. But it was in 2009 I made a video. It was the first time I ever used the phrase in a video where I said, work on your fucking game. I was just talking to basketball players, this 2-minute video, just explaining to them, hey, how do you get better at basketball? Because players are always asking me that. And I told them, stop watching videos so much and go to the court and work on your game. Same way you see me doing it. And a bunch of people picked up on that phrase and they loved the phrase, but I didn't start using it immediately like the next day. It was after a little bit of time and I started thinking, you know, I need a name for, you know, everything that I'm doing that can encompass everything that I'm doing. I said, you know what, that work on your game phrase, people really like that. So now I just started signing off on my videos by saying work on your game. And I just kept using it over and over and people really liked it because it was easy to remember. It was easy to understand. Even if I didn't explain it, you got it. Like, work on your game. Okay, I get that. Everybody has a game. You got to work in order to get better at it. People got it as soon as they saw it, even if they didn't know who I was. People see it on my hat and they're like, all right, work on your game. I like that. So that's when I started using it. And the point that I'm giving you is this. In the process of me being active and putting my stuff out all the time, I learned, all right, this is what people are responding to. This kind of actually is a really good, it's a good message because it kind of encapsulates everything that I'm doing. It works in basketball, but it also works off the court because it doesn't necessarily say you had to be playing a sport. It just says your game. You could be, everybody has a game. The weatherman on TV has a game. A phone repair person who fixes your broken iPhone screen, they have a game. So everybody has a game. So that worked for me when I realized it. That's when I started using it. So being active will help you figure out what that message is. And the more you're out there just articulating whatever is on your mind or whatever it is you want to share or however you want to help people, you will come across it. But you got to put your proverbial 10,000 hours in. It may not necessarily take you 10,000 hours, but everybody's heard of the 10,000 hours rule. You put in 10,000 hours of work to become, you know, super proficient at whatever it is that you're doing. I talked about the 10,000 hour rule, by the way, in episode number 63, the 10,000 hour rule in you is, again, episode 63. You have a link to that down there in the show notes. So we're still on point number one here. Every few interviews that I do, for example, the interviews that I do where I have pursued the opportunity, meaning we created the opportunity for that interview to happen. They weren't looking for us, but we went and looked for them and made it happen. Every few one of those interviews I do, let's say I do 5 to 7 or 10 interviews, usually I get 1 or 2 incoming calls, unsolicited interview requests, because those interviews that I solicited and created the opportunity myself, somebody heard me or saw me on those interviews and said, you know what, I want him on my show. So the more I got active and created opportunities, the more opportunities started coming back to me. It's usually not a 1-to-1 ratio. Let me be clear. It might be a 10-to-1 ratio or 5-to-1 or 2-to-1. But the more active you are in doing the outreach, the more you're going to get those incoming calls coming in your way. And this works not only with, you know, media appearances, this works with doing collaboration work with other people who also are creators. This works the same way in the speaking business. It works the same way in the coaching business. I know a lot of people who are in the coaching business or any type of consulting, where they tell me or they say most of my clients are referral. But how do those referrals happen? First of all, they got to be doing some outreach to get seen, heard, and known. Outreach doesn't necessarily mean reaching out to somebody because you're trying to sell them your thing. Outreach can be doing a podcast. It can be having a blog. It can be being active on Instagram. Outreach can be posting videos to your YouTube channel. Whatever is going to be, just something that gets people to know that you're there. You got to be circulating and have your name out there so people can actually find you. So the more that you go out and create your opportunities, the more opportunities will eventually start trickling back to you. So it is random in a way, but it's really not random. Or once you learn what your ratio is. Okay, so every 3 times I go create an opportunity, I get an opportunity coming in. When you know that ratio, now you know how much work you have to do in order to produce the result that you need. Point number two, and by the way, before I get to point number two, every professional knows what their ratio is and they know how much of what type of work they need to do to produce what type of outcome. You don't know that, then you need to sit down and figure that out and figure out your ratio, look back in your past and your history of your work, because professionals know exactly what to expect of themselves, and that's why other people know what to expect of them, and that's why people are willing to pay a professional. Point number two, today's topic once again is how to get randomly found at what you do. Leverage the attention that others have already created. Basically, what you want to do here with point number two is strategically position yourself to ride the wave that someone else has already created, while at the same time, I'm not saying you just leech off them and take from them and give nothing back. You're going to offer them value, and the value you offer is that you're offering your message, whatever it is that you want to share, whatever you want to offer, you're giving that to that person's audience, because their audience wouldn't get it because they can only get it from you, right? Now, at the same time, what you get is that all those eyeballs and all those ears of people who otherwise hadn't heard of you, they get to see your stuff. So if you're any good, then some of those people are going to become part of your audience. So some of that attention starts to find you. So see what I talked about when I mentioned the Dream 100 strategy back in episode 1835. In other words, what you're going to do, piggybacking off what I said just here in point number one, you're going to be active and you're going to be outside. And when I say be outside, that just means be active and be where things are happening. I told you in episode number, let me find that episode where I talked about being outside. This is episode number 854. Luck strategy is to be outside often. And again, when I say outside, I don't necessarily mean out on the street or riding in your car or something like that. Being outside means don't just sit at home on your couch hoping that your phone rings or hoping that your inbox lights up or that your hotline blings. What I mean is you need to go to where things are happening, and where things are happening might be a Facebook group. It might be you publishing to TikTok. It might be you reaching out and making phone calls and cold calling people and saying, hey, this is what I'm offering and here's how I think we can work together, or here's what I'm selling. Would you be interested in buying it? And even if you don't know what you're doing, get active. Get active and you will learn. We call it activity knowledge. You learn on the job sometimes. Sometimes you learn things ahead of time and you can do your preparation, but there's only so much you can prepare for before you get out there and actually know what's happening. You got to feel it sometimes in life. Random opportunities, everyone. Do not find people who are at home sitting on their hands. Now, random opportunities, never find somebody who's doing nothing. You notice that? That whenever you get lucky and a random opportunity finds you, it usually happens when you're being very active and you're out doing so many other things that you almost wouldn't have even noticed that opportunity if it didn't knock hard enough. Notice that random stuff, random luck never occurs when you're doing nothing. It never occurs when you're just sitting around being lethargic, hoping that something happens to you. So get out there and be seen. If you need to strategize how to do this, again, stay tuned. There will be workshops I'm going to be putting together on the way where I'm going to be talking about all of this stuff and just putting it into a package, a tight package, and making sure that you know exactly what you need to do based on your specific situation. Coming soon. Stay tuned for that. Just stay tuned to this show. And if you're not on my email list, make sure you go to workonmygame.com and get on it so that you are on the list. So get out there and be seen. This is how the randomness occurs. You got to be out there where the randomness can hit you. Point number three. Today's topic, once again, is how to randomly get found. As I just said in point number two, do not wait for randomness to work for you. Do not wait to randomly get lucky. Hoping is not a strategy, folks. What you must do is be intentional about getting yourself seen. And I just kind of explained that in both points one and point number two. Figure out a strategy for how you're going to, not even necessarily how you're going to convert and get the wins and successes, but also how are you going to try? What's going to be your strategy for trying? For example, when I first started to get into the speaking business. This is around 2014 into 2015. I didn't know exactly how I was going to pitch myself. I didn't really know exactly what I was going to talk about. And I didn't know what parts of my background up to that point would be interesting to the event planners and decision makers who hired speakers for their conferences. I didn't know. I didn't have enough experience. I had a mentor, but there's only so much a mentor can tell you about what your value is going to be. They can tell you, they can give you a framework, but you still got to figure out what your value is going to be and what you're offering. So I didn't really know. But at the same time that I didn't know, I decided, all right, I'm going to reach out to 10 people every single day, whether that's by 5 emails, 5 phone calls, or 10 cold calls. And I sat down and I made those calls and sent those emails every single day. And it's not like when I started doing that, all of a sudden the whole world just opened up and no money started falling out the sky and everybody wanted to book me to speak. No, it didn't happen that way. What did happen though, was that when I had those conversations, I started noticing what questions got asked of me over and over again. I started noticing when I was filling out forms, what is the information that they keep asking for every time? I started noticing when people were, if they were saying no, I started noticing why they were saying no. I started noticing what kind of emails got people to respond and what emails were getting ignored. I started looking when I was seeing people who were getting the speaking gigs, when I wasn't getting chosen, I started noticing, all right, what is this person talking about? All right, who is this person? What is she saying? All right, I've seen this person more than once. What are they doing that's so good? I went and looked at their website. So I started finding out what people were doing that was working and why it was working. And I started noticing the things that I was doing that were not working. And I started noticing the things that were working. So then I could figure out, all right, this thing is, these two things work, these 20 things and not. All right, let me do more of these two things. And let me swap out these 20 for another 20 and let's try those out. And over time, I started figuring out what worked. And even with my topics, the way that I was talking about myself and the way that I presented myself, I said, all right, what parts of my presentation are people actually paying attention to and what parts are they kind of getting stuck on and what parts are they not even mentioning, which means I probably should just leave those out because they're probably not helping. And over time, we finally got to this point where I'm at now, and I still consider myself a work in progress because we can always get better and times change and people change, so we're always evolving. But we got to this point where I got work on your game. I have this framework that I've created, and I know exactly how to present it to someone so that they get it, first of all. Secondly, they understand what their audience is going to get. And third of all, they understand how I'm going to deliver it and what they're going to get from it. I have social proof that I'm good at doing what I do there. But these are all things that happened because I got active, not because I was sitting around hoping that because I have this thing that the phone line is just supposed to blow up. You got to be intentional about getting seen, folks. Meaning, go out there and get active. Get some dirt on your hands. Go and mess up. Go make cold calls and get people to hang up on you or not return your phone calls. What do you have to lose? It's not like you were anybody to them before this, so it doesn't mean that nothing happened. In the process of doing this thing, this is what's going to happen. People who you weren't even aiming to be seen by will see you. The very first speaking gig that I did was for the Boca Raton Chamber of Commerce. This is an unpaid speaking gig. Chamber of Commerce is like a local organization. It's a Chamber of Commerce where you live, at least in the United States. Local organization, it basically is just a place where all the local businesses can get together, get to know each other, find out what's going on with local politics and things like that. Just a place to connect, to see and be seen, to network, know people and get known by people. And I remember I reached out to them and I didn't even know that much about the concept of a chamber of commerce, didn't know what they would be looking for or not looking for. I just reached out to a person, somebody answered the phone, and I said, hey, I'm a speaker, I used to play basketball, I'll talk about this. And a woman said, she kind of blew me off, but we'll get back to you. All right, and that's what she said. I said, all right, I made a note. She says she's going to get back to me. About a month later, she did actually get back to me. She said, Dre, I remember you reached out to me and you told me that you were speaking and you said something about you used to make YouTube videos. I said, yeah. She said, well, look, we're doing this event at Lynn University, which is in Boca Raton, and it's about leveraging social media for business. And we're going to have 4 speakers, and we're going to have somebody who's going to speak about Facebook. Somebody's going to speak Twitter, someone's going to do LinkedIn, and we think you would be perfect to do YouTube. Would you do it? And I said, yes. And that was my first speaking gig. How did that happen? It was not necessarily that I knew exactly who they were. I didn't know who the woman was. I didn't even know what the Chamber of Commerce, what kind of events they did. It was only because I was being active. I reached out to the woman, told her who I was, sent an email that said I did this. It was like 5 different things I said about myself. Maybe not 5, maybe 3 things I said about myself. She noticed one thing, because when they called me for that event, they wanted one thing from me. All right, you used to make YouTube videos and now you're talking about business. All right, can you talk about YouTube for business? Can you do a 20-minute presentation on that? I said, yes, I can. And I didn't even know what I was going to say. I didn't even have a presentation. when she reached out to me. I put the presentation together probably the next day, but it was because I was being active that she remembered me. And then when she reached out, all I had to do was say yes to the opportunity. So that's what I mean when I say be active, folks. You do not have to be great at the beginning. It's impossible for you to be great at the beginning. Now, if you're great from the very beginning of something that you do, consider yourself extremely lucky. Most of us are trash at what we do when we first start. I was trash at basketball when I started. I was trash at the speaking business when I started. I was pretty good at podcasting when I started, but I kind of cheated. I had all those hours of making YouTube videos, so I already knew how to speak on the camera. But anyway, you're probably going to be trash when you start, but go ahead, be trash. All right, you got to go through the trash period in order to get to the good period, okay? So this whole point. We're still on point number three here. Most of the random opportunities find you when you're busy out handling your business. That's how it happens. That people from Boca Raton called me, not because I was sitting there waiting for them to call me back. And I never called her back again. I said, all right, they reach out, they don't. Let's move on to another one that I can call. They reached out to me while I was busy doing other things and being active. They say, if you need something done in life, give the job to a busy person, not to somebody who has a lot of time on their hands. Now, why is this? Because busy people are conditioned to get things done. People who don't have a lot of time on their hands are conditioned to, they probably not doing much. That's why they got so much time on their hands. Busy people know how to get things done and get them done quick, and they just keep it moving. And that's why busy people usually get more opportunities than people who are doing nothing, even though it would seem theoretically that the person who's doing nothing has more opportunity. They got more space to do stuff, but nobody offers them anything because they ain't doing anything. Why does nobody offer them anything? Nobody knows who they are. Random opportunities never find you when you're doing nothing, folks. They find you when you're doing everything. Let's recap today's class, which is how to randomly get found. Getting seen, heard, and known is not like winning the lottery, people. There is a strategy behind it. It's not necessarily a science, but it is a strategy. So let me explain it. Point number one, share a consistent message and be active with your message, or be active enough that you can stumble upon and piece together over time what your message is going to be. It was exactly what your host did. I told you about that already. The more you share your message, the more seeds you are planting. That each one of those seeds is a possibility of getting yourself found. So the more you create, the more opportunities will eventually come your way. It's random, but not random at the same time. Point number two, leverage the attention that other people have created. Like I talked about in episode 1835, but in order to leverage opportunities with other people, you have to know them and they have to know you. Now, how do you know people and get known? You gotta be outside. You gotta be active. Where are people at? You need to place yourself where people are so that people can see you and you can be seen. Random opportunities do not find you when you are sitting at home, sitting on your hands. Get out there, be active. If you need to strategize how to do this, understand I'm going to explain this to you, not on this podcast, but in workshops that I'll be having coming in the very near future. Stay tuned. Point number three, do not wait for randomness to work for you. Hoping is not a strategy. Be intentional about getting seen. I've explained many examples of how I did the exact thing with myself. Even when I had no idea what the hell I was doing, even when nobody was responding to me, I was still intentional about putting myself out there because I knew that if I just kept working at it, I would learn and I would iterate and eventually I would find the right formula and I would make it work. And I think I'm to the point where I can say that I figured out that formula. Doesn't mean I won't change in the future, but I think I figured out that formula up to this point as of this recording. In the process of doing these things, people who are not even aiming for you or looking for you, and people you're not even looking for, you will find them. They will find you. Why? Because you're active and you're out there and your name is spreading and your name's going to drop on somebody's head who wasn't even thinking about you. They say if you need something done in life, give it to a busy person, not to someone who has a lot of time. Why? Because busy people are used to, they're conditioned to getting things done, whereas people with a lot of time are used to doing nothing. All right. And randomness and luck never happen to you when you're doing nothing. If you think about it in your own life, most of the time when you got lucky is because you were so active that you were just planting all these seeds of luck and you didn't even know it. And then finally a tree sprouted. That's how it works. Send me a text. Tell me from what you heard here today, what's the most important thing that you're going to use most urgently right now? My number is 305-384-6894. The link to that number is down below in the show notes. Work on your game. Dre, all day. Yeah.